So here I am, a quarter century later, trying to build the same case with the same people in the same location. You would think I would give it up by now, but what is this? We're ready. I'm ready. So it's all about reasoning. And if we really want them to reason, then why are we spending so much of our educational energies teaching them not to reason in favor of memorizing computational procedures they don't understand? And we all know they don't understand. They can't put it to work. We've got decades of evidence that what we've been doing hasn't been working for kids. We're a nation of mathematically illiterate people. The legislature has certainly been making things worse, not better, and crushing kids and teachers in the process. Most of our kids leave us not wanting anything to do with math, but there's an alternative that asks kids to reason from the very beginning and always in their own ways, and that's number talks. And I want to give you just a glimpse into what my fifth graders did after having about 2 months worth of daily number talks, but I first want you to think about this. With no paper and pencil, let me know with your thumb when you've had come up with an answer. Slides, and my kids would tell you you're working way too hard because I don't see thumbs up yet. But as we look at what my fifth graders did with this problem that you just thought about, I want to focus on it. I borrowed this slide from Phil Darrow, but he talks about the arithmetic properties, and I want you to think about the student work and where they're putting those properties to work. So here's a child who says, well, 20 times 48 is 960. But 7 times 48 is messy. I'll do 7 times 50, and that's 350. Whoops, there we go. Or a student who says, well, 50 times 27 is half of 2,700, or 1,350. So I'll take away two of those 27s for 1,296. Now, how come this one took so long and the other one didn't? Okay. I like money. So 48 quarters is going to be $12, and I need two more 48s, so that's going to be 1296. Or the kids who say, can I make this problem easier? And in this case, they half one and they double the other, and say, well, 50 times 24 is 1200, and 4 times 24 is 96, so that's going to be 1296. Or, oh, come on, this is, okay. A lot of my kids came to look at a problem like this and say, well, that's a quarter of 4,800. That's easy. It's just 1,200. But I need two more 48s or 96, so that's 1,296. So to borrow another slide from Phil Darrow, he says you really can't do mental arithmetic without doing algebra. This is algebraic reasoning in its purest form. I can't even remember what's coming here, and I've lost all of my notes. So. Oh, this is a slow slide. This is really good. That makes a lot of sense. We did a good job on this one. Just guess. Just guess. The standards for mathematical practice happening in the classroom. Oh, sure, now you're going to work. So when we take a look at what do we gain by switching to number talks, we gain a lot. Kids really do come to believe that they're mathematical sense makers. They learn to make arguments and judge the arguments that others around them make. They develop productive habits of mind. And I'm not really not asking us to give up a whole lot in the process. I'm asking us to give up those practices that have done a lot of damage to a lot of kids over the years. Practices that have driven most of them away from the study of mathematics. Practices that are leaving us mathematically illiterate, unable to solve the problems that we face in the world. One fundamental thing I want my kids to leave my class understanding, and that is that no matter what the problem is, we don't see it the same way. But if we really try to understand our different ways of seeing and look for the relationships between those, we're all going to see more clearly. And trust me, it's a much healthier recipe for healthy kids and a healthier recipe for a healthy nation. Thanks.